Yes, hello. My name is Martin. Martin Matovu, that is.
Hi, my name is Dora again.
I am an actor, screenwriter, voiceover artist. I am a businessman.
I'm from the Kampala Sun. Yeah.
I am virtually the ultimate hustler.
I still stand by my words. I still stand by my factors. If you don't have money, if you don't have game, and you don't have a vision, well, to a certain limit, you're not going to find love, especially in Kampala.
I love playing rugby. I love watching all kinds of sport. I'm actually a sports lover. I love talking.
As ladies, we love the fine things in life. Shoes, clothes, jewelry, name it. We are not complicated. We just like to have fun. But more so, we love to talk. Even when there's nothing to talk about. Saloon Talk, ladies and opinions.
Once again, we're at Spectra Salon and Spa, the number one salon in Kampala. Don't forget, it's at Salina Plaza, Muyenga Road. My name is Judithiana. I told you that already. I'm here with Martin.
I'm glad to be here, honestly.
And Dora. By the Martin, you need to meet Dora. Dora is, first of all, let me give you just a background. She broke up with her man on the day of the Kwanzaa.
You did?
Yes, I did.
No wonder you're going to make the arguments you're making.
Oh, yeah.
And then...
And I got a ring
then,
on
and
it.
And then she is married currently.
Man, that's paradoxical. You just broke up with the man on the wedding and now you're
yeah, like, that another was one. Like 3 years
and
ago.
And then also the other thing you need to know about her is she feels like the formula to love is money number one, sex number two, and the brains number three.
Oh, God.
That's Dora.
I'm glad to meet you, Dora.
Nice to meet you too.
So we're here to talk about the whole situation of how we women build castles in the air when we're growing up. And you're just like, I need to have a wealthy man, he needs to be handsome. He needs to... But then in reality, we've come to realize they cannot have everything. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, yes.
That he could have the money, but the looks are as if, but not quite, you know?
Mm.
Or he could be very good looking, but he has a vision, but there's no money for that vision. No, he's ambitious. And Dora here chooses to disagree. Dora, actually, the floor is yours.
Why?
Yes, the floor is yours. I need you to help the women who had the dream of having a rich man. So what if I get a not so bad looking man like Martin? Martin, I'm not going to assume you don't have money.
Well, I don't have money. I'm not in her league. I don't have money.
You
so
don't have money. Money. Do you have a job, though?
Man, I do so many things. Of course, I have a job.
You have a job. So, monthly income, we can look at like 2 million shillings.
Man, I don't disclose that. Give the woman the mic, let her say what she wants to say.
Okay, I'm sorry. This show is about to get... It's going to be quite the show. Dora, the mic is yours. Uh-huh.
Okay, you said you don't have money.
Well, I just want to cut it for you, so...
So first of all,
as in, okay, I told you in some where people went crazy on social media.
Yeah, you were attacked on social media.
Yes, I was.
Young and...
Oh, no, it's okay.
Yeah, it's fine. You're
but
married.
Fact mm-hmm. is, mm. you, man, the definition of love in 2015 is money, game, and brains. Now, and money comes first. There is no man who sleeps throughout the day and says, I'm not going to work. No one does that. They go to work simply because they want to make it comfortable for the lady that is coming in. No woman.
So a man could have a vision though.
Vision on paper is nothing. I want money there. I want visible
money.
No,
but vision, I mean, it takes time to build that, to put that vision into reality.
Yes.
I'm gonna put something in here. I'm looking at this shorty right now. Do you know what I'm thinking in my head?
By the way, you are a shorty. Okay.
I know.
I am looking at the world's greatest dreamer. You get what I'm saying? A shorty that overrates herself.
She overrates herself. She is hot. What are you trying to say?
Talking about money. Money is something you talk about money. But are you sure you're that useful to a man's life? Do you think that a woman, you get what I'm saying? The women, the way they take themselves and all this crap together talking about, do you think you're that useful? Do you think you're worthy of my money?
Or can you be without a woman for even a week?
Trust me, I can sleep with so many women when I don't.
Thank you, because you have something that you're giving.
Let me tell you something that you don't know.
Uh-huh.
When you say that you deserve money, then you have to be that important.
No, I'm not saying I deserve money. I'm saying I'm not going to love you if you don't have money.
What I'm saying, I'm going to say this. You guys are taking this argument at a level that I don't believe in. I'll tell you this. Mm-hmm. Men and women, you look at these two people, men and women. You get what I'm saying? You're thinking so much of, you see, love is all about money, love is all about this kind of garbage. The truth is, you guys are overrating yourselves.
We are not overrating ourselves.
Okay.
We are important.
You are important, but you're not that important.
We are that important.
You get what I'm saying? You're putting it to
me. We are that important.
I'll tell you this. And let me give my submission like this.
Oh, thank you.
You get what I'm saying?
I'm waiting.
Money and women, all this thing, because now let us take it, you guys think it's that important to men. I'll tell you this. I am not the ultimate spiritual person, all that kind of garbage. I've made my mistakes and I do not have any shame in that.
Yes, but
being spiritual garbage.
No. I'm not morally upright. You get what I'm saying? I've made my mistakes. But I'll say this. Mm-hmm. I have a few things that I value, and I value the one thing that is called love. You get what I'm saying?
Still believe in these things of butterflies in my stomach.
Hear me out.
I'm listening.
You get what I'm saying? Mm. Hear me out. You're thinking of getting a guy who has money.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying?
Yes.
Somebody that doesn't look that good.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody that is not that good
at sex. I'm going to give you a typical example. Ivan Semwanga.
Forget that garbage about the guy. The guy is a player. For crying out loud, the guy has no respect for
me. Do you know why he's a player? Because he's got something going on in his
He can't
his
even
work.
Have one woman in his bed. The guy just goes on lingering.
He's
just
because of my respect. What he's trying to say.
Listen to me. Let me tell you this.
I am listening.
Listen to me. Let me tell you this. Ivan Semwanga and all those other people that pretend to be this and this. When folks I know are sleeping with their very women right now. You get what I'm saying? Mm. I've led this life all my life.
Yeah,
I've
been told. Around
with you. Hung out with Ivan Semwanga.
I was told.
I have. I know Ivan very well. Mm. You get what I'm saying? Very well.
Does he have game though?
He doesn't have game.
Oh. How do you know you're a man?
Ivan Semwanga is not good in
game. Ivan can win over women like you. You get what I'm saying?
Because what? Because
but the real women, money? But the real women, he can't win over.
Will you? Like oh, so she's not, you? Not, she's not a real woman?
Are you saying I'm not a real woman?
No. The real women, he cannot win over.
Like who?
Do you know why men spend money on people like you? Oh. Because people like you think small. I'll tell you something. I'm not the world's most broke person, but if you're going to get my money, you have to earn it.
How? I'm not a question.
How?
If you're going to get my money, you have to earn it.
How?
And if I don't give you money, it's because you don't deserve it. And the moment you walk out of my door because I don't have money, I don't give a damn.
So let me go straight into another woman's bed.
What are you looking for?
Who you give your money? So what kind of women deserve your money? What kind of women deserve your money? What are you trying to say?
And why do you wake up in the morning to work?
Man,
why?
There is folks that love me. You get what
I'm
saying?
You're working for the people that
I have a legacy to create. You see, men have legacies. We live for legacies. We live for to be remembered way after we are gone. And that's why I work.
Do you want
kids? So my name can be written on everyone's lips way after I'm gone.
Because you have money? Really? Do you see what is going on with Tiger Woods?
We've been here. You've spoken the word money 20 times.
Oh, and I'm going to speak it again.
Okay.
Give me one name of a rich man in Kampala who is not married.
A rich man in Kampala.
Who is not married?
Semwanga can't find a wife.
No.
Semwanga, you told
give
us the problem is that
guy.
He does. He's,
give
he doesn't.
Me a rich name.
So you're trying to say Semwanga is not rich?
No, I'm trying to say.
There is this loser here. This guy is called who?
Medicent.
Forget about Medi. Medi is a joker. This guy. The guy is called who? This girl talks
have you
more
met of, Medi?
How they call him? This girl has a kid who's working with NTV. She's called who?
Oh, Frank Gasuma.
Yeah, man, the guy can't find a wife. He's not a poor man exactly, is he?
And
there's a lot of people that respect him for what he says, whether it's garbage or not.
Okay. Do you concur with me? But do you know how many women want Frank? How many women have actually slept with Frank Gasuma? And I'm
really?
Yes, okay. And I'm not saying I know I have a list or something. But do you know how many?
No. Have you slept with Frank Gasuma?
What makes you think there are so many that have slept
with? Oh, because Bobo.
No, you are a news personnel. You go on scooping this and this. You said you are hiding something.
Guess you didn't know she's a sub editor of Kampala Sun.
Oh, sub editor, give me something about Frank.
Oh no, I'm sorry.
No, you're failed.
Let's get back. Let's get back to the topic. It's come to my knowledge or in my office that man Semwanga has, Ivan Semwanga does have the money, but he can get it on. And then Madison Tongo is a joker. That's of course according to our guest today, Martin. He's an actor. I'm just.
I've run out of words. And
you've run out of words. The topic is what do women? What do they really want to settle for? A cute guy with a vision but with no money, or a rich guy like Ivan Semwanga with the money?
When 45. We are 60 years, you've hit your menopause, you've gotten everything.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? You're looking back at your life, you know? Man, that was this kid that you thought you never loved. You loved so much, but it was just not money.
And that age, he has the money.
So you stick to a guy who was stinking in bed, who was like this louse, really, he was so bad.
Stinking in bed.
He was really bad, eh? You get what I'm saying? But you stick with the guy. Because you get what I'm saying?
Like which guy? Okay, let's give an example. We're trying to visualize here. Like
they
will
attack me. You get what I'm saying? I don't want to be attacked again. You get what I'm saying?
I
want to respect some of the folks that look like me. You get what I'm saying? It's just what it is. This is what I'm saying. You get what I'm saying? At that point, you will look back, you know? This guy will not be exactly as broke as he was, you see? But he will have gotten to a certain level. You get what I'm saying? And you're thinking, God, if I just made that decision to be with this guy, maybe I would not have had all this big house. I would not have. But when we are old and we don't have anything to think about, we're not going to the movies, we're not doing all this kind of crap, we could be together. And you know what you would be? You would be laughing. You would be happy. You get what I'm saying? You would have beautiful kids. You would have everything.
In a V8. Cry in a V8. Than love on a bike.
You're watching Salon Talk. And she just said, she would rather cry in a V8 than laugh on a bicycle. Well, Martin chooses to disagree. You're still watching Salon Talk, Spectra Salon and Spa. Do not go away because Judithiana is coming right back.
Salon Talk, ladies,